guys, welcome back. Okay, so today, I don't know why I always do that. Anyway, I'm gonna put my hands down. Okay, hi guys, welcome back. So today, we just had some blocks arrive. We have 1,000 blocks just arrived. In fact, there's supposed to be another 1,000. What happened to the other?
It's coming.
It's coming.
Yeah,
well, we've basically ordered 2,000 blocks here. And we're waiting for those to turn up because we're obviously gonna start blocking the upstairs where we were afraid about the rainwater coming down. So we want to try and make the building as watertight as possible. So we have a lot of work to do up there first though, because upstairs, in fact, let's just show you. So up here, we have a lot of work to do because before they can bring the blocks up, we have to do some clearing up. As you can see here, That's right, that's what can happen if you're not safe on a construction site, eh? So all this needs to be cleared. So all of this, we have to get the guys to come take all of this. I don't even know where we're gonna put it. Where are we gonna put this?
You have to do it on the front.
We're gonna move it forward a bit.
Yeah. Okay. Yep, they're gonna move it forward. Yeah, this is okay. The big one.
Yeah,
this, so we have the lots. Big race.
We have wawa board, we have timber. We have bamboo, we have everything. It's just everything. I don't know what you're laughing for. I don't know why this guy's laughing though.
No. Oh, because you're making it so common. I like that.
We have everything up here. So
yeah,
now the guys are gonna have to come and basically clear it and then bring the blocks up.
Yeah.
2x2x2 on their heads. I won't be around that day. I'm not going to do anything. So they'll do that, and what we're going to do is we're actually going to set out. So as I explained in the other video, setting out just basically means that we're going to put the blocks according to the room, so you'll actually be able to see the room sizes. We hadn't really planned on actually starting this soon. We were literally just going to cover this, but actually it kind of made more financial sense to just do the setting out.
Yeah.
Because there are a few things that we want to do, because obviously the gutters, we need to make sure that we've done the gutters. So is that right? Yeah.
Yeah, no, it's just the pipe outlet, yeah.
The pipe outlet. So what we're going to do is if we go a little bit to the edge, don't worry guys, I'm being safe, I'm not going to fall, eh? I know some of you get a bit giddy when I go to the edge.
Yeah, be careful then.
Yeah. Yep. So basically what we're going to do is, as the block work comes, there's going to be pipes coming out so that the rainwater, am I explaining it properly? Tell me if I'm not explaining it. So the rainwater will go through the pipes and basically
shoot out temporarily,
yeah, because obviously we don't have a roof and we can't put a roof on at the moment because we still got another level or so to go. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do. So
we can do it, man. We're gonna defeat the game.
Honestly guys, when you're building, it feels like it's a lot of pressure. It's not easy. This is like something we've not experienced before. We've never built a house like this before. I mean, you've built other people's houses, it's different, you don't feel it. But when it's your own house and you're building, right, it feels really, really pressured, and there's just so much to do. And it's almost like you're working with finance and you're working with trades who are have to go somewhere else to come back. And so it's like there's so many things to contend with when you're building. Sometimes it's not very straightforward.
It's but like the storm.
And obviously now we're fighting against raining season too. So it's like everything inside this kettle that's just about, feels like it's about to blow. There's just a lot. There's a lot. You can hear the way Kwame's giggling behind the camera.
But we're fine, we're cool.
Yeah. Dela, he's laughing because he's stressed, that's what he's doing. If you can see here, Kwame has kind of like drawn lines on the floor. So I don't know if you can see, but there's
just the grid lines for the plan.
There's like a rough line here to show basically where everything's going to be. So as you come up the stairs here, it's like a hallway that you walk down, and then you have like the rooms and stuff here. So upstairs,
yeah, upstairs to your that's your right, isn't it?
Left and right is a bit of a struggle for me, I won't lie to you guys. Left and right, I have to think about it. Yeah, so on this side we've got the bedrooms, and the master bedroom is here as well.
Yeah, that goes through here.
But obviously the master bedroom doesn't go all the way out to the edge, it stops kind of like
middle to the center.
Okay, yeah.
It's the same thing, isn't it?
So basically what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring the blocks up and we're gonna just lay it out. You'll be able to see better as to what the rooms are like. It's a bit difficult to explain without seeing, and with all this stuff lying around, see all this. I don't want to be the one lifting and having to move this, because you know what, it's hot up here, I'm not gonna lie, it's very hot. So yeah, we're gonna do that setting out, just so we can obviously put in the temporary pipes, as I've said, for the rainwater to go over. I don't know, Kwame, when you do the setting out, right, tell me how it works, because I'm just like, how do you fix the blocks to the ground? Like, how does
mortar?
I don't understand. I don't get it. Like, if mortar. I bring a block and I just put it here, but it's not stuck, is it? How do you?
No, use mortar. That's the mortar.
It's not like you don't have a foundation, a footing to put it in.
No, that is your beams. All these where you see columns, you see beams. So let me go again. Uh-huh. All these columns that are standing.
These.
Yeah.
Where the iron rods are.
Yeah. In between all of them, mm-hmm. it attaches to another column. It's a net.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Uh-huh. It's a net was woven within a bigger, a smaller net. That's okay. Why you got the in between woofs. But they do blocks of squares. So even the beam, once it's created, you do it into a square or a what's it called?
Rectangle.
Hey,
why do you have a problem with that one?
I don't know what I do. Anyway, in squares, I prefer squares.
So okay.
Them squares mm-hmm. represent grid lines of other squares, bigger squares. That's how you make construction.
Okay.
So it's all them grids. And now same thing with when you're doing it with column bases, column mats, all of that kind of stuff. There's squares within squares. That's why you've got 5 mil, 10 mil, 15 mil, okay. 16 mil, 20 mil. These are all measurements, what you will use for certain lines. Like you can't use 20 mil on the top of here when you've not used the mathematics of maybe 40 mil added with 20 to make 40 mil down at the foundation. You see, that's what I'm trying to say. Anyway, I might be rabbiting.
Don't see, though. I'm just looking at you. I'm like, okay,
yeah,
I'll wait and see what it looks like.
Yeah, yeah, that's what it is. It gets stuck. Yeah,
over
yeah.
my head.
Yeah, that's okay. So it gets stuck. So these columns, what you see here, they're all connected inside this concrete with beams.
Okay, so tell me, so like, when we have these iron rods that are sticking up, that's following through from downstairs,
correct.
Right? So does that mean you have to basically keep the same shapes as downstairs?
Yeah, it has to. Unless you've got a load bearing, unless you've got a particular design, especially because you're doing refurbishment, mm-hmm. if you've got a particular design where it's carrying the load, so you have to find out what the load bearing is on the first building. But like I said, the first building, I totally didn't use.
Okay, we've not put any weight on that one.
Nah, didn't do that.
Okay.
That's why we had so much columns. 20mm columns. There were 20mm right. columns inside the matting and casted on a particular height and mm-hmm. yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. So it's all that kind of stuff. Yeah,
I get you.
Yeah.
Okay, so the guys will be coming hopefully this week to start clearing up and bringing the blocks
up,
because it's going to take them a while to bring the blocks up, because there's a lot, 2,000 blocks. It's not going to be easy carrying it up. No. Me just walking up the steps, I'm like, eesh. By the time I get started, let alone carrying bricks on my head. So boy, those guys, they're fit. But yes, but obviously, even though we're sitting out, the aim is still to get this area covered.
Yes.
So this will be our first concentration, and I think we're going to just raise the blocks. First of all, just how many courses are we going up? We're not going up too high straight away, are we?
You know what? We're getting 2,000 blocks, so let's see what 2,000 can take us. Yeah. That's what we're trying to do. Maybe that's a little competition, isn't it? Let's see what 2,000 blocks can take us.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah.
And the thing is as well, because, you know, we just bought the blocks today, the blocks were three cities 70.
Three cities, 70 pesos.
Three cities 70 pesos. Yes. So it's like, if we continue to wait, like by another 6 months, they're not going to be three cities 70 pesos anymore.
No.
It could be four cities.
Correct.
And so now the cost of having to build here is, for us, is going to go up, especially iron rods. Iron rods have already hit us. We already wish that we had purchased iron rods more in advance, so that we could have done here. We would have saved a hell of a lot of money.
Four.
But unfortunately,
everything on the budget.
It was, you know, when you work with a budget, you work with what you have, so you do what you can. And so,
and you know, amazing, I think when we came here, we had kind of low expectations about how building was here. You think that your money can go really far.
You
feel that, hey, wow, I can create a huge mansion.
Yeah.
You know, if I bought in like maybe 100,000,
mm-hmm.
you know, I get a huge mansion.
Yeah.
So it depends. It's where you get the blocks from,
mm-hmm.
how far the quality. Remember, everything now in the city is harder. It'll be more expensive than outside. Because remember, that's where we're now shipping it from. We're taking it outside of the city and bringing it into the city and sell it for a high premium.
Yeah.
So you see, so if you're moving outside, if you're trying to get sand, maybe outside of Accra, it's far cheaper
mm-hmm.
than you've been in Accra trying to bring sand into Accra. You see, that's what the prices keep shooting. got the demand.
You have to consider transport as
transport,
well.
Yeah. So there's a lot, you know. It's a lot.
Yeah.
And no, the inflation rates start changing.
See, we've got a little issue there, eh?
Hey, wow.
But yeah, there's a lot to consider. So that's the reason that we decided to start the setting now, even though we haven't finished the other level yet. We'll still be working on that, but that's more, I feel like it's more kind of like the interior design aspects that need work down there more than anything else. Because obviously, like I said, now we've got the windows in and, you know, we need to think about power. We need to think about the kitchen. You know, there are big things that we now need to do downstairs. And so that, you know, we don't have it all at the moment. So that's going to take us a little bit of time. So I'm not sure how we're going to do it. You know, we just see it as God there, because we don't know how we make it sometimes. You know, we just keep going and trying to see what we can do.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's the plan. Hopefully this week you guys will be able to see some of what's happening as things progress, but that is what we have in mind at the moment. So we'll just try and get this place watertight, do the setting out, and obviously continue with the inside. There are a few little snags and stuff to do. Like I said, the tiler should be coming any day now. In fact, he was supposed to come today, we're not sure, and finish up the last bathroom for us, and there's a few little things that need to be done, so we'll be working on that as well. So but anyway, guys, I think that's enough talking from me and Kwame today. guys, if you haven't already subscribed, please hit the subscribe button for me, hit the notification bell. Don't forget to also do me a favor and like, comment, and share this video for me. Guys, until next time, I am out. Nozi Papa.